Hey guys, it's Ashley Bornanson with the Red Carpet Report. Today we are hanging out on the set of one of my favorite shows, Switched at Birth. We're going to be talking to the cast, taking you around all the beautiful rooms, and getting some sneak peeks for the season premiere June 10th.
Oh, okay. So you obviously knew sign language when they cast you, right?
Yes. Yeah. It was sort of, if you are going to portray a character with a hearing loss, mm-hmm. you sort of have to have a hearing loss.
Okay,
They interviewed many people, mm-hmm. and some knew sign language and some didn't, but they all had a hearing loss of some kind.
Okay. And I read in an interview you were saying, you know, every person with a hearing loss doesn't mean they talk exactly the same, and that it was kind of like an accent taking on for you.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. But that's one of my favorite things about Switched at Birth. We've shown hearing loss in many, mm-hmm. many ways, and mm-hmm. my own is the same as the character Noah. Mm-hmm. So character Noah has Meniere's disease. Okay. I also have Meniere's disease.
Okay.
I think they sort of put that in there to sort of explain what it is to a lot of people in a wider way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then there's Travis, and there's Emmett, and mm-hmm. they all, I've noticed, are different.
Mm-hmm.
That's really cool.
And it's cool. Something else that's sort of like a subtle detail thing that we work a lot on the mm-hmm. show is the different signing styles. So Regina's signing style, when she was signing, she learned a while ago. She learned 12 years ago. So her sign mm-hmm. for what is not necessarily what we always sign as what. You know, this is the more current what than, you know, so you see this a lot. And it's usually older signers or people who've signed for a very long time. So we pay very close attention to the character's signing voice, which is cool.
Yeah. And you can tell, you know, you're just so, like, obviously, like, fluent in it. So is you know, the actress who plays Regina, was she fluent in it too? Or how did you get to that point? Because it's not like, it's really taking on a foreign language.
It really is. And I think Constance, who plays Regina, sort mm-hmm. of learned her lines and really focused in on those lines because she had to look like she'd known it mm-hmm. for 12 years. And mm-hmm. I think some of the other actors like Vanessa and mm-hmm. Leah and, mm-hmm. You know, Lucas and DW, everybody kind of got to evolve with their character.
Yeah.
But Constance's character, since she knew it already, she had to know it.
Yeah. Did you help a lot in this process, or were there teachers on set?
We have an ASL master for every single time there's any sign language scene on screen.
Okay.
Not that you don't already know sign language, mm-hmm. but just that there's someone there to make sure that your grammar's correct. And, you know, if you sign, and that's where the signer's voice comes in and how big the signs become versus, you know, how small you're feeling in the scene. So your sign language is going to be closer. And you know what I mean? Like it's all very thought out.
And I feel like, I mean, this really opened my heart to, you know, learning more about the deaf community. What has been your reaction from everyone else in this process?
We have had the most amazing feedback. Mm-hmm. We have incredible fans. I'm so thankful for this show. I think our goal here on Switched at Birth is to expose people to a culture that maybe they wouldn't have seen before. Mm-hmm. American Sign Language is the third most common language in the United States.
Who knew that?
Right?
I did not know that.
If you don't know a deaf person, you're really never exposed to that world.
Mm-hmm.
So being able to go home on Monday nights in your own living room and experience this whole other world, I think is what really draws people to our show. Mm-hmm. It's really a window into another place. And mm-hmm. in doing that, we create tolerance, we create exposure to things. And mm-hmm. I think if you aren't exposed to something, it's okay to be a little bit afraid of it. Mm-hmm. The first time I met a deaf person, I was terrified.
Really?
And then quickly found out that they just want to communicate.
Yeah.
And any way that we can make that happen is a good thing, you know? And it's all about just creating this open, loving place. My favorite tweet that I've ever received, ever, was from a person who said that their cousin was deaf. Mm-hmm. And they never had a friendship, they never had a relationship with their cousin before. They saw Switched at Birth, they were inspired to learn sign language, and because of that, they have a friendship with this family member that they had always ignored.
That's insane. Yeah, I learned from the show, from Emmett's mom, you know, that a lot of families doesn't mean the entire family can speak sign language, which really hurt me, even though I'm not even a part of anything at all.
No, but it's tragic. It's heartbreaking. Yeah. And mm-hmm. we have a sort of responsibility to kind of try to educate people now.
What was it like for you? I was telling Ryan, the ASL episode for me, I was like, wait, what? They're like, your TV is not broken. You have to read.
Do not adjust
the dials. And I was like,
oh,
because I like, you know, like closing my eyes sometimes. I'm like, oh, shoot, I have to pay attention. That really affected me. What was that like for you?
It was great. It was a great learning experience to be on set and know that, like, okay, we have to sign every word. because our deaf on it, you know, a lot of times there are words that get skipped over, like the and oh, and in American Sign Language, that's a cultural thing.
Yeah.
But we have to make sure that every word we need has to be signed. Mm-hmm. And I think it was cool because we really spoke to our audience.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the hearing people had to work a little bit,
yeah,
you know, as opposed
definitely.
To the deaf people who are always compensating.
It was a nice challenge for me, I have to say. It was really cool. Okay, so talking about, you know, we should talk about the season coming up, right? I'm like, tell me more. Obviously, you can tell I love the show. So this is really interesting because I feel like your character a little bit got the short end of the stick. You were going to have this amazing family, you know, you did get Regina, which was awesome. But now Regina left to go to rehab and you're getting to experience being really in the Kenish family.
Yeah.
How is that like for Daphne?
I think Daphne's excited about it. You know, mm-hmm. she has a wonderful connection with Catherine.
Mm-hmm.
Like they're twins. They're carbon copies of each other. And
mm-hmm.
it's really good for Daphne to say, oh, this is what I could become. You know,
mm-hmm.
and Catherine's a great role model and a great mm-hmm. example and someone that Daphne definitely identifies with. When mm-hmm. Regina comes back in the picture, it's awkward.
Yeah.
It's weird.
It looked so real though. I was like, this is what would really happen. And I felt awkward watching it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you're supposed to, you know, you're mm-hmm. supposed to be thrown off like, ooh, she's back. And
yeah.
is that a good thing? Is that not a good thing? And,
yeah.
and luckily for Vanessa's character, for Bay, she gets to sort of swoop in when Daphne's
mm-hmm.
not there. And
mm-hmm.
and you kind of, as an audience, get to see what the Angelo, Sorrento, Regina, Vasquez, Bay, Kenish
yeah.
family becomes
yeah.
one. And it's mm-hmm. kind of cool.
Yeah. I was going to, you know, at some point, when I see you and Catherine, it does seem like mother-daughter. It seems way more like that than with her and Bay, you know?
Right.
Just, you guys look alike also, you know, there's just something there, which I think they're supposed to be. At some point, do you think both the characters are going to be like, let's just switch this and be done?
No way. No way.
That can't happen.
I think Daphne, I mean, Regina's mom, you know, like, yeah. like if I found out that I was switched at birth, I am not giving up my mother.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That is my mom.
Yeah. That's so hard because you want both.
Yeah. But you kind of can't.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, the solution to the problem is for everybody to move in together. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy. But I think in real life, if this were to happen, I mean, I'm not giving up my family.
Yeah,
you know, like
that's true.
I'm grateful to have more family to love,
mm-hmm.
but you better believe my family is my family.
I love that. Take ownership. I love that. Okay, we also noticed, you know, with the start of this new season, you and Bay are kind of it's coming strong now.
Yeah.
It's not like little sister here and there. It's like we're competing.
Can't
and
fight.
Now you're both in the office of the senator as well.
Yeah. Yeah, mm-hmm. well, you know, Daphne is high on her previous experience at Carleton, where mm-hmm. she had a goal, she affected a change, mm-hmm. and she feels like she can take that even farther. And
mm-hmm.
having John and in the Senate mm-hmm. gives her the opportunity to be like, I can make a difference.
Yeah.
And I'm going to.
Yeah.
And stupid little Bay is not going to stop me, you know? And
yeah.
and it's good for Daphne to be on this run of like mm-hmm. I am powerful and I can make a change in this world
mm-hmm.
even though I'm young
mm-hmm.
and I think that's what we're really trying to get across.
Yeah. It seems like she's the one who has it all together, you know, like
it seems that way but
yeah.
I'm not sure.
No, not sure, because she, you know, she always gets the boys, she's like the smart one, you know, like everything, right? Are we gonna see Daphne ever get hurt by a boy? Because it seems like the boys always come to her.
The boys are a thing. The boys and Daphne.
I think they
set it up like Bay would be the boy crazy one. But it turns out I think Daphne is a little boy
yeah.
crazy.
And they like fly to her, you know? You're
wow.
like, I can't help it.
What are they
gonna
do? No, but in this season there's a what if episode. So
yeah.
it's sort of like what would have happened if the Kenishes got Daphne in.
Yeah.
And that's a totally different spin on what Daphne is. And that
Ooh.
Was it was amazing to play. It was so much fun.
Cool.
But
and when's that airing? Do you know? Isn't that like July 8th?
It is.
I think the what if episode July 8th.
It
right?
is coming up.
Quick. Okay, cool. Well, this has been awesome. Thank you so much for talking to us, Katie.
Thank
I've
you.
Been inspired. I know everyone else has. Be sure to catch up with our favorite show, Switched at Birth, coming back on air June 10th.
Yahoo!
Coming up. It's exciting on ABC Family.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
And
I'll see you later.
I'll see you later. Thanks for watching the Red Carpet Report. If you like this video, be sure to like it. And for more interviews, as always, subscribe. And check out the season premiere of Switched at Birth on ABC Family, June 10th. We'll see you next time.
Okay, so this is cool. Katie, I have to admit to you, this is one of my favorite shows. I'm not even kidding. I was like, of course I'll come. I feel like I learned something new every time I watch it. Oh, wait, I should do my thing. Okay, this is what I know so far, which is not a lot. How are you? Right?
Mm-hmm.
Good?
Good.
And Vanessa taught me, he's my boyfriend.
Whoa, nice.
She says that's her favorite phrase. So what's your favorite phrase in sign language?
I don't like, so it's like your middle finger, you pull it together, and then you throw it away.
Like.
I don't like mosquitoes.
Oh my God. Mosquitoes. I was not picturing that.
Sure,
okay,
sure.
Let's do that. Okay.
I don't like
mosquitoes.
Like mosquitoes. They drill their holes in your skin. I hate them.
I was not picturing you to say that. I have to admit that, but I love it.
I just love this sign. So much.
Yeah, I was like, that's the reason she loves
it.
It's
so good.
Okay, so
I don't like stilettos.
Oh, stilettos. I like that. Stilettos. I love that. Cool. Okay, so
middle finger.
Flick it. Oh, okay, middle finger. Flick it.
Yep.
Mosquito. Okay, perfect. Cool. Okay.